Yes. It's still.
But you can't be any geek off the street. Gotta be handy with the steel, if you know what I mean.
Keeping it real.
Hello, and welcome back to the channel. My name is Steven, and this is Steel Keeping It Real. So you know what today is.
It's Friday, gotta get down on Friday.
That's right, it's Friday. And I'm back to Female Friday, at least for this week. Now, earlier today, I did do a video from somebody called Jun Somi. It was a K-pop female. And that was my practice at trying to do videos where I can pause and play and talk in between and things like that and have closed captioning on. That was my test, and I think it was a pretty successful test. It just took me way too long to get to where I was today for me to continue to do that for the rest of these videos. I gotta work early on Saturdays and I gotta get my beauty sleep. So this particular video is another K-pop group, and it's called Dreamcatcher, and the song is called Because. B is in capital letters, B-E, and cuz is in lowercase letters. Why? I don't know. But if you like to see videos like these, this and others, just give me recommendations. But please don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit your notification button, because I'm doing at least 15 videos each and every week. So I have no idea. I assume because it's K-pop, it's going to be pop. But I don't know if there's going to be some rapping. I don't know. There's 7 members of the group. They used to be called Minx. This is what I got from Wikipedia. Other than that, I have no idea what I'm getting myself into. So, without any further ado, let's see what Dreamcatcher and Because is all about.
And here we go.
Cause
죽기 전에 흐른 눈물 자국 택한 죄의 직감까지 다 말해 I don't wanna be
'Because.' Now, because of this group, you know, when I initially got on this K-pop rabbit hole with, first it was with Blackpink, and then it was with BTS. Before I entered into any one of them, this is what I expected K-pop to sound like. And it's bubbly and this, but there's a difference in this one because it seems like as opposed to taking certain elements from maybe some R&B and hip hop and things like that, they decided to, at least with this song, add in some heavy metal elements. And this song, in certain parts, sounded like that song that came out, I believe it was in the 90s, and it was called All the Things She Said by Tattoo, and I'll play a little clip in a moment right about here. So, it sounded kind of like that at a point in time, and there were so many things that were going on, because it did that, and it had this little music box kind of sounding at the end, but then it still had that little cute, little almost like maybe something that a 98 Degrees or an NSYNC parts here and there, right? But then you had that metal element, and it just seemed all over the place. Now, after listening to Blackpink, when they did do transitions, and trust me, they did a lot of transitions in Blackpink on any particular song, they actually were in sync with each other. Even though it blew your mind when they went to another transition, you were right there with them. And you know, there was a part of a little bit of hip hop beat where the drum beat got really, really fast. That was a sample of something that was used, and that was about it. I could say I'm confused. There was almost just too much going on, and I wasn't even really focused on what they were actually saying. Because I'm a music person, I listen to the lyrics second and the music first. And if the music, you know, I don't see how you could dance really to this song except for those lighter poppy parts. Otherwise, the other parts will just throw you off. At least with Blackpink, they're all, you know, forms of dance, whether it be Native American or maybe it be Indian from India, or maybe it be something from Asia, or maybe it be some R&B from the United States or some hip hop from the United States. These are all beats when you're putting them together in the way that they put them together, you could dance to. I'm just confused about this. Maybe somebody else can suggest another song by them that would maybe give me a better picture of, you know, what this group is, but if I have to go off of this one, I'm just confused. Now, I know they're a hit because this particular video came out like 5 months ago and already had like 50-something million views, so people are listening to it. I'm just confused. Okay, so that's it. If you're still here, I thank you for staying tuned. Don't rip me apart too much. Like I said, it's my first time hearing them. So, like I said, if you think there's a better representation of them, let me know. Put them in the comments. I'm on to my next goal of 2,000 by the beginning of summer. Let's see if we could do that. All I need from you guys is to like, subscribe, share, and comment. Peace.